Hello, Crankers, and welcome to a new episode of the Crankers Club, my new online method for you to run the Hurdy Gurdy. Come on, it's time to do it. So I assume you just got your new instrument, your Nerdy Gurdy, or your Aplo, your Gurdy Staruch, or whatever instrument. Only you don't know where to start. So I'm here to help you. No worries. Okay. Typically, on the Hurdy Gurdy, we have three types of strings. Here in the center, we have the melody strings, okay, also named as chanter or chanterelles. The amount of strings that you can have here varies. You can have 1, 2, 3, or 4. 2 is the most usual, okay, so you would have 2 or 3. Okay, in my case, I have 4. You can engage and disengage all the strings of your instrument. Okay. What else do we have? The drones. Here, in this side, the outer side of your instrument, you will find the drones, okay? I assume you know what a drone is, but I will explain it too, okay? A drone is a low sound, a low constant sound in the back, okay? Typically, you would have two is the normal thing for drones, or maybe 3, okay? Each one of them will be tuned to a certain note, but we will talk about tuning later. Okay, what do we have here? On the inner side, close to you, we have the trumpets, okay? Trumpet is some sort of an alto drone, high-pitched drone. But it has something special because it's connected to a little piece of wood called the dog. These little pieces of wood here are called the dogs, okay? And they create the rhythmical patterns, very typical of the Hurdy Gurdy. Okay, little disclaimer for the Aplo owners. It's a very nice instrument. It's fantastic for beginners, but it has a little it has only one drone here. And then in the trumpet side, on the upper position, it has another drone. This comes from the traditional French hurdy-gurdies. They tend to have only one trumpet on the bottom. And then on the upper position, it would have another gut or synthetic string, but not connected to any dog. So it would act just as an alto drone. In case of the Aplo hurdy-gurdy, it's another drone because it's not synthetic and it's tuned to a drone pitch, not to a mush pitch. Okay, let's talk a little bit more about the dogs and how to do the setup. Because here, in this area called the tailpiece, this is called the tailpiece, we have some little pegs. And what do these pegs do? Do I need to cut this strange wire that connects this peg to the trumpet string? No, don't do it! This little filament that connects the peg to the trumpet string here in the back, what it does is it controls the amount of buzz that you get. Let's do a test. If I loosen the peg all the way down, I don't get any rhythmical sound, okay? And then I will play a coop. This is called the coop, yeah? The rhythms, the buzzes. Zup, zup, zup. And while I coop, I will tighten the tyrant peg, and you will see what happens. I'm starting to get the buzz. Of course, if I keep tightening, the sensitivity of the buzz will increase. So I will end up having a constant buzz. Okay, and what happens if you keep tightening? Even though you're getting the constant buzz, you keep tightening. You get sounds from hell, which is very typical from this instrument. If it's not set up correctly. If it's set up correctly, fantastic, okay? But, and of course you don't get any sound. If you get this, probably you have too much tyrant. You have to back it up. Done. Fixed. I need to show you what the capos are. If you are looking to get a new instrument, it would be wise to get capos. Okay, capos are a little levers like this one, okay, that instantly raise the pitch of the certain string by a one whole tone up. So now I have the capo engaged, and if I disengage it, C, D, B, C. As simple as that. Okay. So of course, they normally would go in pairs. Okay. If you have one capo on the trumpet, you would want another capo on the drone. You need to know what the bridges are. Okay. So we have three. Three bridges. Okay, this is the main bridge. It's called main bridge because it's the one for the melody strings or melody string bridge. Here we have the drone bridge, and there's the trumpet bridge. Okay, melody bridge, melody strings bridge, or main bridge, drone bridge, and trumpet bridge. Of course, as I explained earlier, you can engage and disengage all the strings of your instrument. Okay, in case of the melody strings, okay, let's disengage everything. In case of the melody strings, you just move them from the little post. As simple as this. I see many beginners that open the lid and then like this, and they connect the string. But it's important to practice how to engage and disengage strings with the lid closed, because sometimes we will do it while playing. So it's important to develop this skill little by little. Okay, what else? To engage and disengage the trumpets, it's not done on the bridge. It's done here. See, I have some hooks that catch the string. I would engage the string and disengage from the hook, as simple as that. So how do we engage or disengage the drone strings? It's simple. It's done on the bridge, on the drone bridge. The bridge has two notches, one that is far away from the wheel and another notch close to the wheel. So obviously, if you put the string on the notch that is far away, yeah, the string will not sound. And if you put it on the other notch, you get the sound. So let's go to tuning. I have some more videos talking about tuning. Really recommend the G-C tuning. You may see in this G/C tuning. This means that your melody string is tuned to G, and your root note is a C. Your root note would be the third note of the bottom row. Okay, the keyboard has two rows, so the bottom row. Third key of the bottom row is your C. In the G-C tuning, the last letter, the C, doesn't mean that the drones should be always tuned in C. Okay, this is a completely different thing. G-C means open string slash root note. Okay, because in the G-C tuning, you can also use your capos to raise the trumpet and the drone from C to D, or you could even disengage your C drone and engage a G drone. Okay, still it will still be G-C tuning. Okay, because this refers to the melody string. Of course, there are other types of tuning, like the traditional French tuning called the DG. Okay, but I think it makes less sense to a beginner, because the F sharp is on the bottom row. Okay, in the case of the G-C, all the keyboard layout is exactly the same as a piano. So white keys, natural keys, are the ones on the bottom row, and the altered keys are all here on the upper row. I know we didn't play in this one, but I think it's important to start knowing the basics. So I will see you in the next one. Keep on cracking. We'll be right back.